Let's get salty!
Hey everyone, Zeddy here again today with a brand new video, and we are continuing our year-end review series today, all building up to the New Year's Eve. It's gonna be on New Year's Eve, a year-end award show. This Zeddy's where we honor all the best cards, worst cards, best decks, all sorts of silly categories. It's a lot of fun. I'll dress up Nova. She'll be there. And I'm also hearing that a possible Blizzard employee might be showing up, so you'll want to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. We keep gaining a lot of subs, and while I would really appreciate it, and it will be a lot of fun. And today we are going over a category. Today and tomorrow we're going over categories that were not on last year's show. I read the comments and I thought this would be a lot of fun. Today we are going to take a look at the most underrated cards of 2021. Tomorrow, obviously, most overrated. And basically today will be, the underrated cards. What cards did I think were not going to be great that ended up being great? What cards did the community get wrong? It'll be a kind of a consensus thing. Tomorrow will be basically just bashing myself over what I got wrong. You'll never guess what cards I overrated anyways. But we're going to go over that. And again, this includes all cards released during 2021. So we got the Dark Moon Races mini set. We've got the core set, Forge of the Barons, United in Stormwind, and Fractured in Alterac Valley. And again, like the prior two videos, we'll go class by class, the most underrated card for each class, as well as the neutral card. So starting off with Demon Hunter, gonna go with a weapon that I felt like I was one of the only people when I was reading reviews, seeing reviews, that people thought this card would actually be any good as a combo finisher, and that's Lion's Frenzy. 3-mana 1/2 weapon that every time, basically for every card you've drawn this turn, it gains attack, and it ended up spawning right out the gate, right out of the United Stormwind release, an OTK, like Brute Lion's Frenzy deck, and it was very good, and it saw Brute get nerfed pretty quickly, and basically you draw through deck and get some 0-mana taunts out to protect yourself and then kill your opponent with the Lion's Frenzy. And if they happen to have taunts, you just play Kane, and you have the whole quest in there to draw through your deck and cheat a bunch of mana. And this card is still a staple. You still see it played in those decks. It's still viable. And it was definitely a card I felt a lot of people didn't see coming. I felt like I did on this one, but I felt like the consensus out there was this card wasn't going to amount to much of anything. Next for Druid is a card that I don't think people saw seeing as much play as it did. I think it came out the Dark Moon Races mini set, and that's Resizing Pouch, the dual class. It's also a hunter card, but it's seen more play in Druid. A 1-mana spell that you basically discovered a card, discover any card for the mana you have left after you've cast it. So you cast it for 1-mana, you have 0-mana left, and then you all of a sudden you can get a 0-mana card. And there's not very many. You have Innervate, Lightning Bloom, Pounce, and a Duskimp, and I think Tiny Fin in standard. And it just does that 1-mana play, really solid. And in the late game, you can get Ysera, you can get Alexstrasza, you can get Nazoth, and now with Guff, when you're 20 mana, you can get a Yogg or something like that. It's just a really flexible, good card that has seen play in a ton of different Druid decks, and I don't think a lot of people saw that coming. It was just kind of like this throwaway discover card. It just didn't seem super reliable, but it turns out at 1-mana, when you have 1-mana, and it turns out again when you have the really high cost, it's actually pretty good and saw a lot of play. And again, it was just one that I felt like fell under the radar a little bit. For Hunter is definitely a card that I saw very few people get excited about, myself included, was Dog Eat Biscuit, the 2-mana spell, tradable spell that gives a friendly minion +2/+3, and if you trade it, you can give a random minion rush on the board. And the rush wasn't I think we all saw this, mid-range, it's going to go in the mid-range Beast Hunter, which isn't that good. It's not going to be good enough, so this card probably won't see play. But no, you just stuck it in the Face Hunter. You hit it on your one-drops, your Arcane Anomaly or your Warple Tinger, and boom, you kill your opponent because it's too much stats. They can't deal with it, and by the time they clear your board, you're a hunter and you can murder them. And yeah, it's just been a staple in Face Hunter, and I don't think a lot of people saw that coming. We've seen, I think, Mark of Nature or whatever it's called in Druid that gives +2/+3 and taunt. If it doesn't see play in Druid, which is a token deck or token strategy, or hasn't seen a lot, why would it see play in Hunter? But turns out just keeping early minions pushing face damage is just very, very powerful in Hunter. And yeah, this card has seen a lot of play since. And again, I don't think that was very, very well predicted. Mage, we have the card that a lot of people did not see coming as a powerhouse, myself included. Vicious Syndicate, Data Reaper report guys, they gave this a 1, their lowest score possible, and then then it's Sorcerer's Gambit, the Mage Quest. We all just thought, you know, it's probably too slow, too clunky to get this done. You have to play all these spell schools a bunch of time, and I mean, your end reward is just plus three spell damage. Is it really that good? Yeah. It is when you have cards like Encanter's Flow, Refreshing Spring Water, Ignite. This was broken, busted, polarizing, ended up getting nerfed to plus two spell damage, and probably one of the most hated cards of the year from Hearthstone, and well, for good reason. It was just way too freaking good against any strategy that was remotely slow, and a lot of us just did not see it coming, and that goes for a lot of these quest lines that we thought they might be a little bit too slow and clunky, and turns out no, they were all very quite easy to complete outside of like maybe priests for the most part. The next two classes, I struggled to come up with underrated cards, honestly, because for different reasons. I'll go over them, so share in the comments below what you think are the most underrated for these two in particular, or if you disagree with my picks, because I feel like, well, let's start with Paladin. Paladin just had so much good stuff all year that people rated most of their stuff good, and it was just good. Like, and for me, I'm gonna go with Blessing of Authority. I felt like people undervalued how insane 8/8 in stats is for 5 mana, even if it can't go face. And then I ended up getting synergy with like the Parrot that could double up on it, or Sidon, which doubles the effect. Like, this card is just a ridiculous amount of stats and saw play in Wild and Odd Paladin. And I just felt like this one flew under the radar when it was announced, and has seen meta play in both Standard Wild ever since it's been in, because it's just so much stats. Like, it's just hard to ignore 8/8 in stats, even if it's a delayed effect to go to your face. For Priest, it's the opposite side of things. Priest has been pretty battle year, and none of the cards are rated that what great, and none of them have performed that great. But I'll go with Shadow Word Devour, the shadow spell that basically it's like a whirlwind, except it eats the stats on all of one minion, and it's been good-ish in like Inner Fire Priest and Wild, and like Miracle Priest in Standard, but none of those decks are thriving. But this card just is doing well, and I just felt like it really wasn't talked about at all, and it's probably one of the better recent standouts in Priest. But okay, I struggled to pick. Like, Serena Bloodfeather maybe for Priest was underrated. No, that card sucks. Like, I don't know, the Secret Paladin, Legendary Paladin, no idea. Fill me in the comments below what I'm missing out on. Next, with Rogue, this one was definitely a bit of a sleeper for a lot of us, and that's Garrote, the Rogue spell that deals 2 damage. You shuffle some bleeds in your deck, I think 3 of them originally, and then, you know, they would go face. And I rated this as a playable card, but I just thought in Weapon Rogue, you know, you just put his extra burn. But a lot of us, I think most of us, didn't factor in the insane effect of the spell damage. The spell damage that when you play it in the late game, you basically OTK your opponent, and is when one of the best finishers in the game still is, even after its nerf, Octobot's nerf. It's just an incredibly good card. And I just, yeah, a lot of us didn't factor in the spell damage. I think that's one of the things we really missed out on, and as a result, just ended up being this finisher that a lot of us, I'm not saying everybody, but a lot of us didn't see coming. And oh my goodness, has Garrote been a powerful card. For Shaman, this is a kind of, you know, a card that wasn't great at the beginning, but ended up being really good because of all the support. So I guess it was initially underrated, it was kind of justified, but in the end it was underrated. And in the long run, that's Perpetual Flame, originally 1 mana, now 2 mana. Deal 3 damage to a random enemy minion. If it dies, you do it again, and it overloads 1 each time. And it was like, this is a expensive AoE in the regards that the overload's crippling, but with United to Stormwind, we had the overload quest, we had overdraft, and all of a sudden it wasn't that bad to overload. This is just an incredibly good card, and it ended up getting nerfed as a result. But when it came out, everyone's like, why would you ever play this? And well, it ended up being a card that people couldn't stop complaining about very quickly after United Stormwind's release. So probably justifiably initially underrated, but overall it was still wasn't even that bad at the beginning. And I think I probably gave this a 1. I know I dunked on this card, so yeah, not fantastic. And next we have the Warlock card that is well, I've probably made more videos about this card this year than any other card, and that is the Demon Seed. Vicious Syndicate gave this a two out of 4. I don't think I rated this high. I think I gave it a 2 as well, at a 5, and it was just like, you can't self-damage this much, you're gonna die. And turns out we have an insane amount of healing in Warlock, the wind condition's ridiculous, you have Flesh Shines, you have just so much ridiculousness around the Demon Seed that we've had over 7 to 8 card, I think it's actually around 9 to 10 Warlock cards outside of the Demon Seed, and the Demon Seed itself got nerfed, that it's still the best archetype in Standard, arguably. It's still Handlock, Demon Seed, Warlock is still arguably the best archetype, and we weren't sure if it would be that good. We're like, eh, it'll be, you know, might be all right. No, it's ridiculous. Got banned in Wild, and even if we all gave it 5 out of 5, we'd probably be underrating it at this point. It's been that busted, and yeah, I just have to give it to the Demon Seed because a lot of us were not super sold on it. Some people saw it coming. I won't lie. There are some people that saw it coming, but some pretty prominent people definitely missed the boat on that one. For Warrior, this card wasn't very prevalent in the later parts of the year, but it was super underrated early on from Forge of the Barons conditioning. The ranked spell that would every time, like, you get to 5 mana, so it starts off at +1/+1, all minions your hand, then +2/+2 at 5 and then 5 mana, and then when you hit 3 mana or 10 mana, it's +3/+3, and this was incredibly good in Rush Warrior. And I'm not doing this to tout my own horn, but I gave this a 3. I'm like, it'll see play. I think people are underrating this, and it saw play. It was pretty good. It was like a 4 to 5 star card during Forge of the Barons, and it fell off because the board just stopped mattering. And if Warrior had access to more charge minions outside of Grom, this card would probably see a lot more play. But when your charge is available as like Grom and now Mr. Smite, conditioning doesn't matter as much because Rush doesn't matter as much because the board doesn't matter as much. So it fell out off, but initially was really underrated and was very good early on in the year. And for the neutral cards, there's a couple to pick from, but I gotta go with the Far Watch Post. This card was originally a 2-mana 2/4, and every card your opponent draws costs 1 more. It got nerfed to a 2/3, and people were just like, why would you play a minion that can't attack? Yeah, it makes your opponent's hand slightly more clunky, but how powerful is that? Very powerful. This card was nuts right out the gate. Saw meta play in Standard and Wild. Still does as a 2/3. And I feel like very few people really got the concept that Far Watch Post would be that good. Myself, I thought it would only be good in like a Rally Priest. That's where I saw it. Ironically, it was more like a Rally Paladin that kind of made it work in Wild, at least. And yeah, Far Watch Post, criminally underrated and really impactful card. And there you go. That's my picks, my suggestion for this. Again, feel free to share in the comments below what you feel were the most underrated cards, and tomorrow we'll take a look at what I horribly botched and overrated. So if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Have a great day, and stay salty, my friends.